Alpha 7 back in April. That is the last time we saw anything tagged for this project. And if we go to the System 76 blog, there are some posts. There's one in the battle laptop here, open source summit, 10 years of memories, another laptop one, and then Alpha 7. This is the last time there's been anything, you know, super official mentioned about the project. So does that mean the party's over before it ever began? Does that mean the Cosmic Desktop died before it ever lived? Died before it even made its way into the beta? Well, no, that's not what's happened. But I wouldn't be surprised if you started to think that way if you were just looking at the Epoch repo. Despite the lack of tagging, if we go to parts like the panel or the store or the compositor, so the last patch here for the panel was 13 hours ago. If we go to the history, we have a bunch on September 1st and August 28th and August 12th and August 9th. So clearly work is being done here. On the store, again, if we go to the history on the 28th, 27th, 23rd, 19th, 15th, bunch of work, and the same thing for the compositor as well, 15 hours ago, and then a bunch of other work on various other days as well. Even though there hasn't been a tagged release in a very long time at this point, work is absolutely still being done. Even though there hasn't been any official announcements on the System 76 blog, System 76 website, that doesn't mean that people involved in the project haven't been talking about the work that has been going on. And Carl Rochelle, the CEO of System 76, has been talking quite a bit about Cosmic. For example, the Cosmic Store, their graphical package managery thingy, if you like those, now supports using Flatpaks. If for some reason you want to use a GUI tool to install Flatpaks, personally, I don't really care about that. I just do it all from the terminal. But for people that like this, it is there now as well. And here we have a little image of Cosmic running on the still not yet released PopOS 2404. Now, this is a bit of a side tangent, but I'm curious to see what the perception around PopOS is going to be like when this version actually releases, because 2204 is still the latest version, and ever since that release, there's been sort of quite a bit of change in the Linux distro ecosystem in the areas that PopOS used to get a lot of attention, in things like the gaming space, where now you have distros like CashiOS and Bazaar and a whole bunch of others that often get recommended for gaming and get a lot of attention. So when PopOS 2404 actually does release, I'm curious to see if it's still going to have that same sort of attention, at least in that SKU. Maybe in other areas it's still going to be popular, but honestly, I really want to know what that's going to be like. And when this does release, I'm definitely going to have to speak to Carl again about it. Then we have some random stuff about theming. This is not new to the project. It's just showing off, hey, look, you can very easily change your color scheme. It's built right into the tooling. No need to work with some weird configuration file. It's just all right here. Now, there is a weird configuration file if you want to work with, if you want to do some more advanced stuff, but you don't have to. Theming, native, first party, right there, no need to worry about it. And talking about this does give him an excuse to just randomly post themes as well, along with music that does not fit at all with the theme that he's talking about, which probably deserves to have some Windows Movie Maker transitions. Go to his Twitter account, have a look at the themes he's been posting, find the one where it's showing a video because I cannot play the music here, but you'll see exactly what I mean. Showing off features like being able to drag an entire workspace over to another monitor, which I think is neat, not a thing I'm going to use on a frequent basis, but is a nice feature to have. And about a month ago, talking about the Cosmic Desktop at the recent Open Source Summit with Jeremy Soller and Carl Rochelle. For some reason, their comments are turned off. I don't know why they turn it off. I don't know why they do this, but that is a thing as well. And recently, there was an article from LinuxEAC talking about System 76's initial setup completion. This is pretty much based on a thread posted on the System 76 Twitter. Here we have a little tool for configuring various things you might want to configure upon first opening Cosmic. We have the screen reader, the interface size, additional scaling options. I still think this is a weird option and they probably should change it. And then having the magnifier there. These posts here just go over what each of those things do. And then you have the option to set a theme right in the welcome page in the initial setup. Of course, if you don't like any of these themes, you can just go and configure it to whatever you want, but it does set up the idea initially that there is native theming built into Cosmic. This is something that is very important to the project. Despite how some projects might feel about it, theming is not going away in the Linux desktop in general, and it is definitely not going away when we are talking about Cosmic. We have some basic panel configuration. Do you want a top panel and a bottom dock, or just a bottom panel? I generally use the bottom panel. I'm not a big fan of having two bars on my screen. I feel like it's just a waste of space. We have some basic introduction to what Cosmic is. New system applications. Enjoy an array of new system applications that come with the Cosmic desktop environment, including settings, Cosmic App Store, files, text editor, and terminal. Of course, all being written in Rust because System 76 loves Rust, and speak to Jeremy Soller about Rust. He will tell you how much he loves Rust. Anyway, we have some explanation of what workspaces are, how workspaces work, why you might want to use workspaces. We have some explanation of the keyboard shortcuts, and we have the launcher here as well. And then it takes you into the desktop. Now, welcome screens and initial setups like what KDE has, I think are considerably further along here. But keep in mind, Cosmic is still technically in its alpha. And for an alpha, I do think this is totally good enough. It is a functional and good enough looking system that gets the point across. Now, could things be added? Could it be further polished? Absolutely. But even the fact that this is just here during this time, I think is a good position to be in. But the super important question, the million dollar question, is when is there going to be a tag? When is there going to be a new release of the Cosmic desktop that people running the tag packages can actually go and use? Now, you may recall this video from long ago at this point. I like to bring it up because it's funny, where Carl said the beta release would be in January or February of this year, and then first release would be February or March. Right now, we are in September, and we are still technically in the alpha. So, that deadline definitely wasn't hit, but whilst Carl was a little optimistic, and I will continue to bring this slide up until the day the project actually has a full release, there is something that was said recently about when this is going to happen. Recently, Carl said to someone as a reply, "We're announcing the beta release date next week. It will be in September." So this is an announcement for the announcement of the beta release announcement. I think that's the right number of announcements. Now, is it actually going to release in September? I believe the date will be announced in September, but we'll see if the beta actually happens then. However, considering that it's been, you know, 4 or 5 months since the tag now, and a lot of time has been spent polishing things, and things should be in a considerably better state, there is hope that we'll at least have the beta release this year. Now, do I think we're going to have full release before the end of the year? I have extreme doubts, because once December rolls around, there is a lot of holiday stuff going on, people are taking time off, and people are just generally not working as much. If things don't get fully released by the end of November, I think we're going to be waiting. Look, you know what? Maybe Carl was right. Maybe it will release in February or March, but he just got the year wrong. You know what? I think that's a high probability. Now, even though the release was quite a bit later than anticipated, and we haven't seen a tag in quite a while, there is still a lot of work going on, and I am very excited to see at least the beta release, because I've not tested out in quite a while. I should go back and actually check it. I was speaking to Carl about a month ago, and he was saying that a tag was coming sometime soon. That was about a month ago, so... Look, just because Carl says that a date is coming up, that a tag is happening, I like Carl, right? I'm friendly with Carl, he's a good guy, but he's not exactly the most, how do we say, reliable with dates, we'll say. So I think we'll go with that. It's like Valve time. It's System 76 time. It happens when it happens. It releases when it releases. And I will be there when it releases. So, are you excited for Cosmic? Are you going to try it out? Have you tried it out already? Or are you waiting for maybe a beta or a full release? I would love to know. So, if you liked the video, go like the video. Be sure to subscribe as well. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to Liberapay, link in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and space is fake.